Okay, so the final topic for today is thinking about converting between these representations. And so let's think about which of these following conversions are going to be safe. In other words, the value is always going to be preserved. We're always going to be able to take a value on the left-hand side and convert it to a value on the right-hand side. So smaller unsigned to larger unsigned, smaller 2's complement to larger 2's complement, larger to smaller unsigned or 2's complement, unsigned to 2's complement, or 2's complement to unsigned. And I think at this point it's going to be very, very useful for you to actually pause the video and think through each of these scenarios in your mind. And even if you're unsure, at least make a guess as to yes or no, this conversion is always going to be safe, or yes or no. Okay, so let's work through each of these in turn. So think about converting from a smaller unsigned format to a larger unsigned format. So maybe going from 4 bits to 8 bits. And hopefully the intuition that you have here is that this is going to be safe, because you can always represent the same numbers in the larger format. You'll just have more numbers that you can represent. In order to convert from the smaller number to the larger number, you just pad it with zeros at the beginning. This is called zero extension. So if, for instance, we were taking a value that can be represented using 4 bits in unsigned representation, so for instance 5, we can change that to an 8-bit representation simply by adding zeros at the end. So what about doing this in 2's complement, so going from a smaller number to a larger number? And again, hopefully your intuition is that this is going to be okay. You can always represent a smaller number in a larger field. Except that now if you're doing this with a signed format, in particular 2's complement, you have to do what's called a sign extension, which is related to the difference between an arithmetic or a logical shift. So basically you extend using the first bit. So if the first bit is 0, then you pad with zeros, and if it is a 1, you pad with 1s. All right, so what about going from a larger number to a smaller number? So from 8 bits to 4 bits. And hopefully with a little bit of thought, it's relatively intuitive that this is not going to be safe using either unsigned or 2's complement. Basically, if you have a number that doesn't fit inside the smaller format, you're going to have an overflow. You're going to have to lose some bits. So there are some values that you can represent using the larger format that you just cannot represent using the smaller format. How about unsigned to 2's complement? The intuition here is that, you know, there's that range of numbers that in unsigned represent positive values, but in 2's complement they represent negative values. So if you have one of those large positive values, you may be able to represent it using an unsigned number, but you're not going to be able to fit it into the same size field using 2's complement. And so you'll also get an overflow. So for instance, if you try to take 13, which we saw earlier, and we try to represent it using 2's complement, you're actually going to get a number that is not the number that you're looking for. Some numbers are safe, right? So for instance, 5 is safe. In particular, we know it's going to be safe if that first bit is not set, right? So if this was a positive number, a small positive number in the unsigned representation, it's still going to be a small positive number in the 2's complement representation. And then hopefully this then leads to the correct conclusion, which is that you can also get overflow going the other direction. This one's perhaps a little bit easier to understand. So 2's complement can store negative numbers, unsigned can't. So if you have a negative number represented in 2's complement, it's simply going to become a large positive number in unsigned representation. And so you cannot always do that conversion safely. So these are important things to keep in mind as you're working in low-level encodings and as you're writing programs in C, because you will occasionally need to convert numbers between different formats. And it's important to think about when you can do that safely and when you cannot.